Unit GC2, Controlling Workplace Hazards. Element 1, Safe Movement of People in Their Workplace. Key information, pedestrians are exposed to various hazards as they move around the workplace. These hazards can cause slips, trip and falls from height, collision with moving vehicles, striking by moving, flying or falling objects, striking against fixed or stationary objects. These hazards can be controlled through the risk assessment process and by careful design and construction of the workplace. Some key controls are use of non-slip surfaces, spill control and good drainage, designating pedestrian walkways, fencing and guarding, using signs and PPE. Information, instruction, training and supervision. Routine inspection and maintenance of control measures. Hazard in the workplace. When people move around in the workplaces, they are exposed to a range of hazards can be categorized by the type of accident that they cause. Details of these categories, along with some typical conditions and environments in which each hazard might arise, follow. Slip, trips and falls on the same level. Typical slip hazards, smooth floor surfaces that are inherently slippery, for example polished marble, wet because of spills or cleaning operations. Contamination of a floor with a slippery contaminant, for example oil or leaves. Frost and ice, for example outside pavement in winter or the floor in a freezer. A person's footwear can make a big difference to how vulnerable they are to spilling on a floor. Typical trip hazards, uneven or loose floor surfaces, for example broken paving slab, poorly laid floor mat. Trailing cables, for example the cord of a vacuum cleaner. Objects on the floor, for example a bag left on the floor. Note, that people frequently trip over their own feet. When people slip or trip, they often, although not always, fall to the floor. Though falls on the same level do not always lead to serious injury, they may well lead to broken bones, especially in the hand, wrist or arm. Falls from height. Typical hazards, working next to an unprotected edge, for example on a flat roof, on the deck of a partly built scaffold, by the open doors of a lift shaft when the lift is at another floor, by an excavation, working on a fragile material above a drop, for example on a fragile roof, on a skylight, using access equipment, such as a mobile elevated working platform, or cherry picker. Using ladders, such as a step ladder, extension ladder or fixed vertical access ladder. Standing on object to reach high levels, for example using a chair to reach the top shelf of a storage rack. Falls from heights, even a low height, often cause very serious injury and are a common causes of fatal injury. Construction work routinely involves work at heights. Collision with moving vehicles. Typical hazards. Pedestrian walkways that require pedestrian to walk in vehicle traffic routes, for example in a warehouse or car park. Pedestrian crossing points. Exits that open onto vehicle traffic routes. Areas where people have to work adjacent to moving vehicles, for example road works, loading bays. Accidents resulting from these types of hazard are again often the cause of serious or fatal injury. Striking by moving, flying or falling objects. Typical moving object hazards, automated machinery such as a spot welding robot. Unsecured objects, such as a container on the deck of a moving ship. Typical flying objects hazards, ejected parts, such as swarf, sharp metal waste, ejected during metal drilling. Thrown objects, such as scaffold coupling. Typical falling object hazards, loads falling from heights during lifting and handling operation, for example boxes falling from pallet when being lifted by a forklift truck. Object being dislodged during work at height, for example slates dislunged from a roof during roof work. Objects falling from heights because of adverse weather conditions, or wear and tear, for example scaffold boards blown off a scaffold in strong winds, duct work falling from a ceiling due to deterioration of fixings. Toppling of unstable objects, for example an unsecured ladder, a poorly stacked load on racking. Though people are not injured by falling objects as often as they are by vehicles and falls from heights, the injuries received may well be serious or fatal. Striking against fixed or stationary objects. Typical hazard: objects that project into a pedestrian area or route, for example stored stock metal sheets that partly project into a walkway. Narrow doorways in a pedestrian route. Low overheads, for example pipework at head height above a gantry walkway. Maintenance activities. All of the above incidents can occur while a person is involved in maintenance activities, because maintenance engineers often work in locations and situations as a result of a fault or problem. In the areas the hazards discussed earlier may exist, there may be spillages, damage to floor, confined areas, low ceilings, poor lighting, vehicle movements, etc. Control measures for the safe movement of people in the workplace. The control strategies for managing the risk inherent in the movement of people in a workplace are based on basic health and safety management principles. Eliminate the hazard. Create a safe place. Create a safe person. The starting is risk assessment. Risk assessment. A risk assessment covering the safe movement of pedestrian in a workplace would identify the various hazards that present risk to pedestrians, identify the groups at risk, workers, members of the public, etc., and those who might be especially vulnerable, young children, the elderly, people with certain disabilities, such as visual impairment, etc. Evaluate the risk by considering the existing controls, the adequacy of those controls, and any further controls required to reduce the risks to an acceptable level. Be recorded and implemented. Be subject to review as the workplace changes, in response to incidents and perhaps periodically. During this risk assessment, it is important to consider the normal patterns of movement in and around workplace. Predictable abnormal movements, such as taking shortcuts, fire evacuations, accident history of the workplace, which might indicate problem areas. Impact of adverse weather conditions, such as wind and rain. Maintenance requirements of the various controls, for example floor surface cleaning and repair needs. Slip resistant surfaces. All floor surfaces where people may walk should be designated to ensure an appropriate level of slip resistance. If this is not done during construction, then slip resistant surfaces may have to be fitted or applied at a later stage, for example by applying a non-slip resin to an existing floor. Several factors will affect the kind of slip resistance that is required. The number of people who walk on the floor. The footwear those people might be wearing. The wear and tear that the surface will be subject to, for example vehicle traffic, foreseeable spills and contamination on the floor, for example chemicals. Environment conditions such as weather temperature, or sunlight. Spillage control and drainage. Floor and pedestrian routes should be disaggregated and constructed to withstand foreseeable spillages. Such spillages might simply be of water, for example drinks. But in other instances might involve oil, fuels, for example diesel, solvent or corrosive chemicals, for example sodium hydroxide. Spills must be controlled to prevent slip hazards and degradation of the floor surface itself, which can lead to potholes and trip hazards. Spill control is best achieved by preventing the spill from happening in the first place. This might be done through either maintenance and inspection, for example of pipelines, valves or taps. Behavioral controls, for example banning drinks from an area. If spills cannot be prevented, then measures can be taken to prevent them from contaminating walkways and floor, for example drip trays under leaking oil sumps, buns around storage tanks. Where a floor or pedestrian route is likely to get wet, then adequate drainage should be provided. Outdoor walkways may be subject to rainfall. Indoor walkways may be subject to frequent wetting during normal use, for example shower rooms and changing facilities, or cleaning operations, for example in a food production factory. Designated walkways. The use of designated walkways is a critical control measure in many workplace situations. Walkways can be used to try to ensure that pedestrians stay within designated areas. Vehicles or other hazards do not stray into pedestrian areas. Designated walkways can be used in many different situations, such as to provide a safe pedestrian route through a car park, warehouse or loading bay area, where vehicles will be present, through a workshop, factory or across a construction site, where hazardous work activities, such as lifting operations, may be carried out. Guardrails, providing direct physical protection. Curbs and pavements such as outdoors, adjacent to a vehicle road. Marking on the floor. Fencing and guarding. Fencing and guarding can be used in a variety of situations to control hazards to pedestrians. Guardrails, to designate and give protection to pedestrian walkways. To protect an edge where pedestrians might fall, for example at the edge of mezzanine, or a path near a cliff edge or steep slope. Perimeter fencing to prevent access to construction sites. Guarding and perimeter fencing to prevent access to dangerous areas near machinery, for example an industrial robot. Temporary fencing to prevent access to a hazard such as a pothole. Use of signs and PPE. Clearly visible and easily understood signs and markings should be provided so that pedestrians, even those unfamiliar with the workplace, are made aware of hazards and what they must do to avoid them. Signs should conform to relevant standards. Prohibition, for example, no pedestrian access. Warning, for example, forklift trucks operating in this area. Mandatory, for example, high visibility PPE must be worn. Safe conditions, E.G. fire escape route. Hazard warning markings, for example yellow diagonal stripes on a black background, should be fixed on the pedestrian hazards, such as the edges of step, that are not obvious, and overhead obstructions. Hazard marking might also be used for vehicles. PPE may be necessary to protect pedestrian from various hazards as they move about the workplace. Some of this PPE will protect them from specific hazards inherent in an area, for example ear defenders in a high noise area. More importantly, PPE might be used to make them more visible as a pedestrian. High visibility high-vis clothing, such as coats, over trouser and tabards works by speeding up reaction times. A pedestrian wearing high-vis can be identified as a person quickly and from a greater distance. For example, a car driver can see when a highway worker is in the road in front of them, the driver will see them sooner, be able to identify them as a person more quickly and therefore be able to take early or evasive action.